Good morning, everyone. And for the record, if you don't bother noticing, I got a different pair of glasses on. Before I address the reason why I'm posting the video, last night, yesterday afternoon, well, about 2 weeks ago, I went to the eyeglass place to get my annual eye exam. And the good news, and this is the craziest thing, according to the doctor, my eyes have gotten better compared to what they've been in the past. I've been having to use very, very strong prescriptions. I know technically these are these particular glasses that I've been wearing. I can't. If I put them in black plastic, it would be like that thick. But they have condensed them in certain types of deal. And I'm able to wear glasses, but my prescriptions are very, very thick. And for the last 30 years, I have been having to wear these glasses off and on. And I got so many pairs of glasses that pretty much it's pretty bad. And I mean, like I said, I got like, to be honest with you, I got... We would like to eventually be able to get laser surgery on our glasses, but if you look on camera, you literally see me full four pairs of glasses. I actually got five pairs of glasses.
So do I.
Total of six nearby, including these glasses that I've been doing, which is considered PC glasses. And so these were the glasses that I'm getting ready to retire. But I can still see out of them. But with this prescription, I'm able to look on computer screens again for the first time in a long time with my vision glasses, because these prescription isn't too strong for my eyes. But with this entailed, there's a reason why I'm posting a video today. I want to address one person in the audience.
Can I say something?
What?
To all the tornado storm victims in Texas, hear my thoughts and prayers. A lot of tornadoes hit Texas and a lot of other states, caused massive damage to homes and businesses. Even somebody lost their life in these tornadoes. You hear my thoughts and prayers.
Okay. But the reason why I want to post a video discussing a topic here today, a few days ago, people was under a misunderstanding, thinking, oh, I'm bragging and boasting about my plans of retirement. When in reality, that's not my intentions. My intentions, and to be very blunt, is I'm foretelling to certain people because I'm giving them a warning. I'm telling them flat out, this is the way it's going to be, kind of a thing. If more and less, it's intimidation, more than bragging and boasting. And when I say literally, it's for other purposes, it's letting them know up front the journey could lead into a certain direction. Now, what got me to this point is a question. And this rolls into a situation that I had stated on YouTube way back in 2006. Something that is a very, very real story. And I'm going to re-emphasize this story because it's going to pan into the future. Way back in November of 1995, there was a very, it could have even gone into September. I just don't remember the exact date. I'm getting that old in the years. I would say 26 years old when this incident happened. Actually, 24, if I remember my dates right. I was working at a place called Casper's, which was a restaurant. It was really one of my first real jobs that I ever started. And at that time, I didn't know how to drive, not like I do today. So I was getting around on a bicycle at that time. And I think I was going to Rent-A-Center at the time. I think I was I had purchased something. I literally went to Rent-A-Center to go get it. The item, or make a payment, or something like that, and I got on my bicycle and I was driving back to the restaurant because I was on a lunch break. Lo and behold, there was a vehicle driving at night without any lights on. At the time, I thought it was Ravishing Recruit, but it wasn't. Driving. He was a passenger in the vehicle. It was actually, in real life, it was a Lunder Blaze. You know her as Medusa. Well, today you know her back as a Lunder Blaze. If she's watching, I have no hates or regrets. It's past. That stuff's gone in the past. But the consequences of the incident that happened. I wound up hurt, fracturing what's called a scaphoid. A scaphoid is a little tiny bone that is right here in the wrist scrim. If you look right here on the camera, you see I have the scratch, this scar, still yet. Well, they put a screw into the wrist where the scaphoid is. But doctor told me at that point in time that literally he would not clear me to work. In fact, if I had not done what I had done, he still to this day would say, I can't work. Because 18 years passed. 18, 20 years passed. And then it even went into 30 years. And to the present day. And 4 times they have taken an x-ray of my wrist to look for that scaphoid fracture. And every single one of the doctors looked and said, yes, you still have that fracture. But it's not just the wrist that's causing my issue. Because now I have back issues. The realization that I wanted to be very plain and simple. When I was working in the packaging center business, I've never used my left arm to be able to lift skids, lift things. I've always done it with my right arm. Because I've told everyone that I can't lift with my left arm. And the realization is that literally I cannot lift with my left arm. The doctors have now said to this day that I can't lift anything with my left arm because of the scaphoid fracture in my arm, which means that I can't do production work at all. That's not bragging, boasting, because I don't like it, okay? But this is leading into something that I've not told people, and I'm going to say something that's going to be a bit of a shock. Because when I plan things out, I plan things out far in advance. I planned my retirement far in advance, even though the date sort of got pushed up a little bit for me. But with COVID-19 going on, everything going on in my life, and with what recently happened to me, with being diagnosed with something that I've not told people on YouTube about. This is all leading to a certain direction. And that's a total retirement. But if you think that I'm going to just 100% not do anything and just sit on my ass all day, not work a real job, none of you know me very well. But I don't want to address the business company that I'm posting in this video. I don't want to talk about what the book is coming up with. But rather, I want to talk about my plans. Because that unknown person who's watching this video, I want you to be very, very aware of what my plans are. And I want you to really, really think about what your actions have been. You see, two things that I want to address. I want to address 101 3rd Street in Doe Run, Missouri. I want to point out certain things about Missouri law and Missouri real estate. If you don't purchase and you don't pay the taxes on a property, some very unforeseen things can happen. Especially with the person who's been secretly paying the taxes and not telling people that they've been doing it. You see, what no one has known, I did it in Florida, I did it in North Carolina, I did it in Utah, I did it when I was living in Missouri. Certain person has been paying taxes on the property. And even this past year, I paid the taxes on the property. I could decide to bring all of them receipts to Missouri and show the courts the receipts on the property.
Wait a minute, you've been paying taxes on property?
Now, I want to make this clear. But I want to also emphasize what my true plans have been this entire time. You see, back in 1995, when I first got injured, I did originally apply for disability. But I didn't take them to court. Okay? I did not take Social Security to court about the issue. And immediately you're going to say, well, you can't get that. I actually thought the same thing. Believe it or not, I actually thought the same thing that you thought. But then I got a phone call, believe it or not, from the Social Security Administration. And what they told me is that with that original doctor's note, which said that I could not get Social Security, that I could be able to get temporary disability, what I found out was that I can be able to claim all the way back from 1995. I have no idea how this all works and the law about this, but I spoke to an attorney about it, what they said. And at first he thought they were wrong. But then he looked into the disability law and he said that I was right, is what I was told. Now, this is all up to an independent judge who makes that decision, kind of a thing. But if this is correct, then I could wind up being paid almost $800 a month since 1995 on this. Because there's no statute of limitation on what a claim can be made.
Wow.
Or I can get the past 2 years taken care of. Now I say past 2 years. I applied, but from my understanding, it takes 2 or 3 years before a determination can be made. And let's say 4 to 6 months a decision is made, and then from there it goes into the courtroom, which would mean almost a year and a half of having to argue with a judge about my condition. And keep in mind what the original doctor said in 1995 is valid to today. Who made the initial determination and said that I cannot work. And that I should not have been working this entire time. So, let's say that I get the 1995 determination that happened involving the law, involving the 1995 deal, and I'm paid all this time, way back from 1995 until today, to get the determination. Do you know how much money that's going to be? That's a big payout for me. And where do you think I'm going to invest the money in?
Kenny, look.
Number one, I'm going to invest the money in buying property, a house. getting myself for the first time in my life, get myself into a nice little home.
No, a she shed.
That I can retire at, and she can have a she shed.
Away from him.
And the whole thing is that the property would be mine. No one else's property. Which means I intend to have a computer room. Which means I'm going to invest in a decent computer. Something that I dreamt of being able to have. So I can sit down and do YouTube videos and do gaming videos with the way that I want my gaming videos to be produced and being written as. Let me keep in mind one thing. Push comes to shove. I could do this on 101 3rd Street. But I'm not for getting 101 3rd Street. Okay, I'm not really after that piece of property. And keep in mind, I'm not giving you the correct address. I know it's on 3rd Street. But I don't want to divulge that. For personal reasons, privacy reasons. I'm just referencing the title 101 3rd Street. But I want to also very keep in mind that it's going to be where the property is that I'm going to purchase. It could be anywhere in the United States. Where I want to retire. It could be in Fresno, California. It could be in Oakland, California. It could be right here where I'm at in the state. It could be in Seattle, Washington. It could be a property in Ohio. It could be a property anywhere, including Plano, Texas, Garland, Texas, Shelbyville, Illinois.
Gotcha.
It could be anywhere in the United States. It could be at your back door. The thing is, it's going to be where I am going to do my business. You see, the whole point is the fact that I'm looking on permanently retiring. And the whole plan is not necessarily, and someone made a comment and said, oh, I'm bragging and boasting. I'm not bragging and boasting. I'm saying that I've earned my right to retire. I'm in a situation that, first of all, I have no choice to retire. But at the same time, I'm out here saying, you know what? I am going to be publishing books. I am going to be selling books. I intend to publish video games. I'm not going to be 100% in a situation where I'm not doing something. You see, the fact is that I've earned my right to retire because of my medical issues. And I have worked and worked and worked and almost killed myself because of something that I have no control of. And I'm not going to continue working and working and working and getting my condition worse and worse and worse. If anything, I'm expressing myself very clear to members of my family about my condition. Because I know that certain people are watching this video because I can see everything going on my video feed. The message that I'm going to make is plain and simple to you. Is the fact of the matter is that I could decide to go to your backyard. I could decide that I can be 2 or 3 miles away from where you live. I could be 1/2 mile. I could be 3 blocks away from where you live. You see, I'm going to make that decision on where I live. You're not going to make that decision. Because I'm free to do what I want to do. I would prefer more than likely, I'm going to tell you what's probably going to happen. I'm probably going to go to possibly to some place like Seattle, Washington, somewhere up here in the Northwest. Probably, depending on how much money I'm making. I'm going to get myself a decent car. And it's not going to be like the car I got now. I'm going to retire that car. I'm going to put that car out of its misery. And I'm going to get a decent vehicle that's going to be very decent to drive. Very decent thing. Maybe even an electric vehicle. And be able to get in and enjoy life. Maybe be able to get a vehicle where I can go fishing. And do things that my dad used to do. Maybe for the first time ever in 45 years, go bass fishing. Because I like fishing. I've always loved fishing. And I love bowling too. The point is, the fact is that I'm doing something that I've always wanted to do. I couldn't because of financial reasons. But the point is, I want to retire. I want to retire. I want to enjoy myself. I want to get into a situation that I can just sit there at a place that would be, I could be there until the day I die. And be able to live out the rest of my life in happiness. Write books, publish books, talk to people about books, getting into the issue of trying to help people who are wanting to get into careers and helping them make their dreams come true. And I'm saying this in all due seriousness in this video. The point of the matter is that if you thought a few days ago I was bragging and boasting, I'm not bragging and boasting. I'm telling you my plans, because in that way, you know what to expect. You know exactly what I'm thinking about. And that's what I gotta say. Thank you.